In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon his last and beloved Messenger Muhammad, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. This is the seventh part of a series entitled Discoveries from the Quran. And in this series, I show the superiority of the knowledge of Allah God Almighty in the last revelation to people, the Quran, and how the knowledge of Allah in the Quran is far superior to the knowledge of people in this day and age in all branches of knowledge, and how that a believer, by pondering upon the verses of the Quran, can be the teacher of others. So among the topics of this part is the one you see on the screen, the future of thermal and sound insulation. So in our homes, in the house, we need thermal and sound insulation. And what do I mean by thermal insulation? Is that we need some type of material in the walls of the house to minimize heat transfer, the transfer of thermal energy between the inside of the home and the outside, such that if we accomplish this, if we minimize the amount of heat coming in from the outside and going out from the inside, we minimize the requirements for heating in the winter, for example, and air conditioning in the summer. That's thermal insulation. Now, soundproofing or sound insulation is another kind of technique for insulation, is that to minimize the amount of noise that comes from the outside inside the home. And the benefits from soundproofing or sound insulation is that if we have a quieter house, a calm house, your psychological status, you become calmer and more productive. So the question now, what is the optimal method for thermal and sound insulation? Now, as we are used to in this series of episodes, instead of depending on trial, error, and guesswork, let's go to the Quran, to the last revelation of Allah God to people. And in the Quran, by pondering upon two verses, Allah teaches us the optimal material and design for thermal insulation and soundproofing. So the first verse to ponder upon is verse number 21 of chapter 51 of the Quran, which reads, this is translation, "And in your own selves will you not then see." So Allah, God Almighty, is urging us here to ponder upon our body and how he created the human body. And one of the reasons for this is that if you think of your body from an engineering point of view, you realize that your body is an optimal, it's an optimal engineering system. It's comprised of many engineering systems. And if we link this to another verse in the Quran, in chapter 95, verse 4, Allah states here, "Verily, Allah God created human in the optimal form." So Allah is teaching you also that your body is created, is optimized, meaning we can learn from this that the engineering systems in your body, they are working at 100% efficiency. So your body is working at 100% efficiency. So if you want to find any solution for an engineering problem, just look into your body. So here is the conclusion from this, that if you want to find a solution for any engineering problem, you have in your body engineering systems of all kinds working at 100% efficiency. So just look at your body, study your body, and you find a solution. So let's apply this to the problem of thermal and sound insulation. We want to get the optimal way to achieve this. Now, if we search, where can we find thermal and sound insulation in our body? If we look at the human skull, we see that it contains the brain. And the brain is a very sensitive organ for temperature changes and also for vibrations and mechanical vibrations shaking the brain. So, since Allah is teaching us that he created our body in optimal form, this means that the brain should be optimally insulated for thermal changes and sound, mechanical vibrations. So the next step is to see how Allah God Almighty accomplished this, how he achieved this. And we find that the main mechanism for thermal and sound insulation in our skull is the design, is how Allah the Almighty created the human bone, skull, the bones of the skull. And if we look here, we find them. We see that there is a very kind of marvelous design here, is that you have like a sandwich structure. You have two stiff layers here, two stiff ceramic materials, because Allah teaches in the Quran that He created the human body from clay, from a ceramic material. So not only Allah teaches us the design, but also the material to use. So the optimum material for thermal and sound insulation is to use ceramic material and to have two stiff outer layers, and we have in the middle like a cellular, like a spongy kind of material, ceramic as well. So the optimal design for thermal and sound insulation, from pondering upon two verses only from the Quran, is to have a stiff layer from ceramic material on the outside, and then we have on the inside a spongy, like a cellular material. And to explain this more, I did a computer model based on the creation of Allah the Almighty for the bones of the skull. As you can see here, the blue plates, they are the stiff ceramic materials on the outside, and this green one right here is the cellular or spongy material in the middle. And the reason I did it in a hexagonal pattern, because bone is hexagonal, it's composed of hexagonal cells, like the beehive, like the cellular, the hexagonal cells for of the bee habitation. So this design here is the best design for thermal and soundproofing. And also Allah teaches us what material to use, ceramic material, like clay kind of material, ceramic. So this is design, that's it, that's the answer, the optimal design. And no wonder that people, after years of trial and error approach, they found that the best design to achieve thermal insulation and soundproofing is the one you see here. Look at the astounding similarity between the design, the creation of Allah Almighty for the bones of the skull, and here the engineering kind of modern kind of top science recent designs. Here we have a stiff outer layer and a cellular inner layer, and interestingly the cells, they are in hexagonal pattern. So if you compare that, the one I just showed you, that this one is learned 100% from the Quran and pondering upon our body. And you can see here the design that people came up with after years of trial error approach for thermal and soundproofing of homes. So you can see, brothers and sisters, how how a believer can be a teacher of others by pondering upon the Quran and the magnificence of the knowledge of Allah in the last revelation to people, the Quran. And to know more details about this topic, please visit my website at www.quran-miracle.com. This is the website right here. And you can email me at zaidquran@gmail.com. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all.